Hello everyone, welcome to AITech1.com. This is my new video in Salesforce Lightning series. And in today's video, I'm going to demonstrate you how to configure dynamic forms in Salesforce. So let's try to figure out what exactly dynamic forms are. Basically, dynamic forms was announced in Dreamforce 2019 as one of the features in user interface enhancement in the roadmap in admin and lightning keynotes. And dynamic forms, it is used to show a particular section, or we can say dynamic forms, it helps to transform the static data into intuitive experiences. Using dynamic forms, every engagement is data driven and responsive to user input in real time. And I must say that this is going to be a game changing feature. It will give admins and the consultants the ability to have the granular level control on the record pages. Using dynamic forms, we can customize these sections and the fields of the page as per the business requirement. For example, we can show a particular section when a pick list field has a certain value, or if the opportunity has reached to a certain stage, we want to display a section with relevant fields. For example, if the customer has reached out to a point, to a target points or to the target limits, then it will show a next section in front of the customer so that the customer can fill out that form. So there are fewer page layouts to maintain. So in the previous version of Salesforce, we used to control this with the help of layouts, but with the help of dynamic forms, without creating multiple layouts, in a single form, we can manage everything. There are certain limitations also, and some uses also dynamic forms. So we can add the components in the page and select the fields to add in the section and create a filter on a dynamic forms to define when to display the section, whom to display the section, or what form factor to display the section, so on. And there are limitations, as it's mentioned that dynamic forms is only available on custom object, not on the standard object. And it is available only in summer 2020 release as non-GA preview. And dynamic forms are not supported on record pages that use pinned regions or custom page templates. So this is about dynamic forms, and I believe that dynamic forms will help you out a lot in future. So let's try to have a look at how can we implement the dynamic forms in our Salesforce. And for this, what I have done, I am using one scenario here. And in this scenario, what I'm going to do is I'm going to demonstrate that I'm having one Salesforce application, and I have built a custom application like online training management. And in this online training management, we have a list of courses, trainers, students, class scheduling, and so on. So there is an object called courses. And in this object courses, let me open this form. Although there are very few fields, there are only 5 to 7 fields are there. But my requirement is that if I logged in as administrator, I would be able to access all the fields. If any other user logged into Salesforce and access the courses, he will be able to access only course name and course category and course fee. Course duration, I want to hide it from. In the existing version of Salesforce, we used to control this with the help of creating multiple layouts. But now we can control this, we can manage this without creating multiple layouts with the help of dynamic forms. So let's have a look how can we create a dynamic form. And in order to implement dynamic forms, so first of all, we have to do is we need to enable dynamic forms in our Salesforce app. So I'm going to do one thing. In order to enable the dynamic forms, I just get to the setup, and in setup, I look for dynamic forms. I look for record page settings. We have to look for record page settings. In user interface, you will find out record page settings. In record page settings, as you can see, I have already activated. So it break up your record details into individual fields and section components that you can put anywhere on the field. So I just checked this out, and it's clearly mentioned that dynamic forms for non-GA preview is for desktop only. It is not available for the other version. So this is full view and this is a group view. So I have activated this. Once I activate this dynamic form, so the next step is we need to navigate to the custom object. So I'm into custom object now, the courses. And I click on this gear icon and look for edit page. Click on edit page. When you click on edit page, it will redirect you to the Lightning App Builder. And in this Lightning App Builder, you can see a component has been added. A new option has been added at fields, and in fields we have a new field component added as a field section. So this field section will be only available once we enable this option, dynamic form. Now what I'm doing is I just drag and drop this field section in my detail page. I'm on my detail page and I drag and drop this section in my detail page. By default, it's a two column. We can customize this one column or two column section. We can change the label also. So I'll just say label as course details or course information. Course information. So I just add a section, and on this section, I need to add the fields which I want to display. So as I mentioned that I just wanted to display the course ID. That's an auto generated one, course ID. And I want to add course name. Course name I want to put in this section. Course category I want in this section, and course fee I want in this section. I just put it here, course fee. And course duration. Okay. Now, as you can see, I'm not able to put the course duration. And why it's not that? Because it is not a required field. As you can see on right side, it is saying when I try to add a course duration, it won't allow me to do that in this section, because in this section here, if I try to do that, I can add only the required field. But let me try to do it again. I just set course duration and put it here. So course duration is also added in this section. And it's a required field or read-only field or no, none. So I just add the section. Now you can see the look and feel is changed. This above section is a different form. And as I decided that I'm not going to add a course duration, and instead of course duration, I just wanted to add course fee. So I just add a course fee here. So now the next requirement is I've got two users. Let me show you the list of, let me show you the two users I have. And one of my user working as an administrator, one of my user working as a sales profile, custom sales profile, named as Adit. Now what I wanted to do is I would like that if the user with admin profile logged in, he will be able to access only this first section. And if the user with custom sales profile logged in, he would be able to access only this course information section. So for this, what we have to do is we have to add filters. So I select the first section, and there's an option called add filters. So I'm going to add filter here right now. So let me add a filter. So click on add filter. And click on advanced field. So I click field. So I select field, and this will be available only to a user. So this will be available only to a user. And to which user? Which user we wanted to show. So we wanted to display to a profile, and profile name equals to what? Profile name equals to system administrator. So this is my profile name, system administrator. And I just copy this system administrator here and done. This is one. And as you can see, as I have added a filter on this section, you can see a small orange icon is appearing. It indicates that a filter has been applicable on this section. I select my second section and add a filter on this. Same method, advanced, select users, profile, name, done, and it should be equals to custom sales profile. So I'll just copy this custom sales profile and paste it, and done. So as you can see, we have got two sections. One section will be available only for administrator, and another section will be available only for custom sales profile user. So that's all we have to do. We can do more with this custom dynamic forms. So I just click on save, click on activate. I have already activated it, so it's already done. Activation is already done. Let me click on back and let's check it out. So at present, I logged in as administrator. This is my profile, and I logged in as administrator. So let me see when I refresh or click on any of the record in course object, I can see the first section. You can see second section is not visible to me, although the second section is also available, but it's not visible to me because it is filtered out that the second section will be only available with the custom sales profile user. So I have another user named as Adit, and this user is a part of the same org, and this is Adit. I logged in as Adit here, and this user is working as a custom sales profile. Let's go and check. So I click on course ID or any of the record. I select on any of the course, and you can see I'm getting course information where we have course ID, course category, course name, and course fee. This is a custom section we created. This is a custom section we added. So like this way, we can work with dynamic forms. So in order to display the sections, in order to display the fields based on the user profile, instead of creating multiple layouts, we can use dynamic forms. So dynamic forms will be very useful in upcoming. So that's all in this video. I hope you like this video. If that's so, don't forget to press the like button. If you want to get more updates on new upcoming videos, please subscribe our YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that whenever we add a new video or some new updates, you will get notification on time. So if you require some customized training on Salesforce or on other topics, visit our website, www.aitechone.com. You can write to us, or you can connect with us on this mail, this contact number. That's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.